Tama. And that completes our picks. Jordan 4 is going to be the last to enter the fray. Let's get the show on the road. On the blue side, it's going to be Empress Phoenix. Welcome to Wild Rift, everyone. On the red side, naman si RTZ, Athena right here. Aggression right here by the red side. They're going to be invading four champions here, ganging up. Let's see if this becomes something bigger. No, they will just go for the invade. On the blue side, blue team. All right, EPX is going to be responding with an invade of their own. Orianna and even the Jinx is going to be joining this steel right here. Ziggs will try to get in, but Ziggs, you have to be careful, my man. There it is. No engage. Boom. Just pokes right there. But that is to be the early game for us. I think we're going to be having a good time right here. Let's introduce the champions.
Yeah, and EPX, you can see Akane on that Orianna, Pawe the Jinx, Dora on that Lulu, Mina on that Wukong, at saka Zuri naman sa kanya Shyvana. Pero dito... Ay, sige, go. Wala yan, Rick. Ipakilala mo muna.
1-3-1 setup right here on RTZ. Unay natin si Vivi on the Jarvan 4 jungler. We have RTZ Vagini on the Alistar support. We have Ayabade on the ADR Kai'Sa. And then we have Psyche on the Gragas Baron laner. Quinn naman on the Ziggs. Mage spawn ng team staying in the Dragon lane.
Yes, and gusto ko lang bumalik doon sa nangyaring early game na, early invade na nangyari. They opted for the parallel jungling, pero ang ginawa dito ni Vivi ay mas kinuha niya yung wolf. Habang ito si Kazuri, bumalik ka agad siya sa red niya. So medyo ahead ang J4 in terms of XP.
Alright, there we go. Battle of the Rift Scuttler. It's very important. Always spawns at 1 minute 25 seconds of the game. Both sides nag-clash dito sa baba. So, but the red team, it's blue team EPX who will get the first Scuttler. That's gonna be the bottom side river. At the top naman, kukunin ni Gragas yung Scuttler. So, one Scuttler for each. This is a pretty even game as of this point. 2 minutes in.
Yeah, and going back sa point natin kanina, yes, nakakuha ng extra wolf camp si Vivi, pero mas mabilis ang clear ni Kazuri. Ang Shyvana, yes guys, hindi man siya gaano, wala man siya gaano CC, kundi tulak lang ng Dragon's Descent. But remember, it's on 2 seconds cooldown. Kada meron siyang rage, pwedeng-pwede siyang tumalon or pag may naipon siyang Dragon Empowerment. So, okay ang Shyvana na utilize ito ng EPX, and at the same time ang Flame's Breath, ang lakas ng bawas niyan guys sa mga tank. You have a 3.25 damage doon sa maximum health nila. So mga tanky people, nahihirapan pagkaharap ang Shyvana, pero gank potential na kay Vivi. That's a J4, it might be roaming onto the bottom side.
Alright, but it is a roam, but blue team is gonna be prepared for it, so it will not turn to something bigger. Sabi mo kay Shyvana, yun lang ang kaya niya, but man, don't forget, andyan si Orianna, who can always put the ball on top of the Shyvana.
Yes, yes.
And then, pagpasok ng Shyvana, the shockwave can be on top of her. That's gonna be very scary, so red team will have to still watch out for that right there. 3 minutes 15 seconds into the game, first Drake of the game, makikita na natin, it's gonna be the Infernal Drake. Spawning the next 40 seconds. I think this will break the status quo of both sides in the map right now. Mukhang magkakabakbakan dyan. Ganda ng warding ng red team deep into the jungle of the blue side.
Yeah, and yun nga eh. Dapat si Vivi gagak agad siya. Pero kung usapang warding, parehas. May mga deep wards yung mga kuponan natin. And right now, they are aware of any possible rotations na pwedeng gawin. Kita mo, dalawang ward kanina, tatlo na wala,
yes,
na lang
tama.
Alagang-alaga yung bottom side. Remember, this is a Kai'Sa and a Jinx. So gusto nila, makuha nila yung item, yung power spike nila, and they can transition into those big leads. Pero first fight, pending sa Dragon Scuttler, one step ahead ang RTZ. This is a bit different. Nakita natin kanina, EPX ang siyang nauna sa mga objective. But right now, RTZ, nagkakatansyahan lang muna dito. Konting poke lang. And they're just converging sa mid. Wala pa rin gaanong play na mangyayari. And ito yung nakakatakot. Tulad na sinabi sa atin guys ni Leoric, ball delivery na manggagaling sa Orianna. Pwede mo siya ilagay sa decoy. And yun nga, hindi natin mapapansin na pwede biglaan na lang mag-cloud yung Wukong into the Cyclone, into the Shockwave. Napakadami na pwede nilang gawin. Pero Dragon, being start off. At ito na, Shyvana!
Oh, papasok Shyvana, but half HP lang. It's gonna be Jarvan 4 takes the dragon right there. Shyvana's not feeling well right now. Shyvana's gonna first clash with the other fight. And here we go. We're not done yet. Ganda ng pasok dito na Kaisa. But Kaisa is gonna go for the chase right there. Orianna will be able to escape. Only one casualty in that fight, and that is Shyvana going down. It is going to be RTZ Athena who will take the fight of the game, and they will get the first dragon of the game 5 minutes in.
RTZ Athena, so close, paring Leoric. Void Seeker, kung kumapit yun, pwedeng na-isolate si Dora at mahuli. It was also a good explosive cast para right. Magkalat-kalat after na magdikit-dikit dahil sa Dragon's Descent. Even the Cyclone, alam natin right. Na mag-set up si Mina. So, explosive cast para magkalat-kalat at walang mahuli. All in all, RTZ Athena, one step ahead sila from the Dragon, and even those skills, sobrang binabantayan nila yung kilos ng Empress Phoenix.
Go the fight. Nakita mo naman ang ganda ng poke this 6 dito as blue team is gonna be taking the first curse of the game off the top. That's something for them in return. They're just down 1k right now. Pero ang ganda kanina eh, ang zigs, ang mga poke ng red team. That is what you really need to do. It's either poke the enemy out first. That's already a win for you, or kill someone, eh, di ba? Pagpasok ni Shyvana, only half HP left on that dragon, and she doesn't look as scary anymore. They collapse on him, and then Shyvana was out already. But Shyvana gets the Rift Herald instead. Okay lang yon. Hashtag not essential naman yon at this point. So, red team, they're gonna go pressure the top lane.
Yes, and the movement ngayon ng EP XLA mas proactive sa pag-group up. Pero yung Ziggs may iwan mag-isa dito. You know, the siege capability of Quinn. Pero aware siya, huwang-kuha yung warding spot para malaman kung may magtatangka against Quinn. Pero ang ginagawa lang niya, pinopoke lang niya, bouncing bombs, tamang hanap lang. Habang sa top side, good answer na manggagaling. So RTZ, yes, nakuha man yung Rift Herald ng EPX. Good timing also sa pagsira nung Tore para cleared na sila sa pagkuha. Kaso yun nga lang, hindi naman nila na-defend yung top. So i-defend man nila yung top, masisira yung mid. Pero either way, nasira na rin down. Yung mid at top. So, walang magandang bottom. Exchange. Right? Oh yeah, even the bottom. So, walang magandang exchange na nangyari. You got the Scuttler, pero one step ahead pa rin RTZ. And at the same time, hindi mo malang nagamit yung Scuttler to equalize the tower breakdown. So, ang daming nawawala ngayon para sa EPX and RTZ Athena. They're just doing their own thing.
Alright, yun nga, sabi natin, Rift Herald is hashtag not essential right now. 3/3 are essential though, and because of that, we're looking at a 5k gold lead. It is gonna be Rift Herald summoned here at the bottom side. Tignan natin para sa Anto. I think it's kind of early. They could have used that for the dragon right there. Dragon takes, since may Shyvana naman dito. There is gonna be a steal right, 10th steal right here by the red side on the red buff. Pero Kaisa already very low right here. Alistar doing Alistar stuff with 3-man pulverized right there. That's gonna be big. Alistar's very, very tanky right now. TPN by the Gragas. Blue team will have to back away. Cataclysm is gonna catch one, but flash forward. Oh, Gragas wills a very big ultimate right there. Says the Jake is in a bad position, and 3 points from the 6 from downtown, and this Goldie. Is bad for blue team right now. Wukong will try to protect the team right there with the Cyclone. We'll get one champion down. 6 gonna go down, but Orianna will almost dying, but will find an exit. So does Vagini, and that's gonna be it for the fight. It will end with a 2-for-2 exchange, man. What a fight.
Sayang, tamang-tama si Leoric doon. Sana ginamit na lang nila ng bandang late yung Herald just to make sure na mahirapan sila in contesting between a split push with the Rift Herald or the Dragon. Take note guys, ginamit yun sa bottom side and hindi rin successful yung Rift Herald on taking the bottom tower. If you opted on opening it sa mid lane, masira yung mid lane, makakuha ng Dragon, mas malaki yung chance na magkaroon sila ng movement sa mapa. So I think the good part na lang is using it sa mid lane. Kung hindi man nila gagamitin yun pang split push para hindi ma-pressure. Pero ngayon, nahihirapan sila. And RTZ, nauna na naman sila dito sa tower.
Alright, tama.
I miss the Dragon, sorry.
Yes. Dragon's already down. It's gonna be Jarvan 4 with that tick right there. Remember, there's initiation right here by the Alistar. Alistar will send out the ultimate. Good job by the Vagini. We'll start the fight. Orianna with a big ultimate right there. Alistar will go down because of that. But red team, you're in trouble this time. It is blue. Oh no, big cast right there by the Gragas. But still, it is going to be EPX on top of this fight, and they will take two champions. At the very least, they even out the scoreboard, and we're looking just at just a 3k goal lead this time.
Yes, and good decision making coming in from EPX. Shortcomings lang sa RTZ, kinulang lang sila sa setup, pero right now you can see yung ating Kaisa. You have the Blade of the Ruin King na naka-ready na para dito sa tanky lineup ng kada naga-Dragon's Descent para maka-kite away siya. Kasi delikado eh. Whenever na matalunan siya at maipit siya, kasama ni Mina, that Cyclone from Wukong is threatening. One good thing about this is Dora already got the Ardent Sensor para kay Pawi. Mm-hmm. But Pawi is still medyo lacking pa tayo. Mostly, mas nararamdaman mo talaga ang Jinx once na nakakuha na ng runa, ay once na may runaan sa dumuramdam yung damage. So ngayon medyo nag-ano pa, hindi pa ahead yung mga ADC natin, and 4-4 tayo sa scoreboard. Konting ano pa to, team fight pa or good team fight para masabi natin na kung sino man ang makakakuha ng mga objectives na yun.
Alright. Story you can look at the, right now in this game, man, is the dragon count. 2-0 on the dragon count. Remember, blue team, 0 sila. May Shyvana sila. Shyvana without any dragon buff is para si James Ridriana na walang Milo. Sabi nga, eh, di ba?
Oh.
Not enough energy.
May so energy Shyvana,
may energy gap. This Shyvana is not looking that scary at this point because no dragon buff is under her hands. Tignan natin, red team is gonna be, it's going to be pressuring the mid right here, but this is not going to be turning into something big. But at the bottom, it's going to be a different Mina. You need to get out of town. You initiate right here by the Alistar. Dragon form is going to be used right here. Alistar's already very low, and they're going to chase with a happy face because it is going to be corned beef for dinner tonight. Alistar goes down.
Nahuli. Masyadong nag-over to mid yung ating Alistar, and they didn't really convert yung sa kill. Nagano sila eh, sinubukan lang mag-3-man dive against Mina. Tama. And you gotta respect Wukong. You have the decoy, you have Cyclone. Napakadami mong pantakas, even the dash. So I think sobrang off na untargeted mo is Wukong. And right, hindi rin healthy pa yung bottom tower. So it's not really a good chance to take para itumba yun. Mas okay pa siguro kung nag-split push na lang sa top side. But right now, EPX, they are one step ahead. They want to take the mid lane tower. Matatapakan ng Chompers, VV, and initiation. They're just going to back off. And Dragon, mukhang minamatahan na kaagad ng RTZ ulit.
Yeah, this is one thing that's going good for RTZ right now. Whenever there's Dragon, sila ang priority eh. Ang ganda ng pwesto nila kaagad. They deward the area already, dropped some wards right there so that they will know where blue team is gonna be coming in. And because of that, nakita niyo yung resulta, 2-0 on the dragon camp. There's a good ward right here on the tribush for by the blue team, pero mawawala po yun. Ayan, ganda ng vision ngayon ng red team RTZ for that dragon right there, and wala so far from the blue side. So that's what's going going well for RTZ right now.
Yeah, and ang nakikita lang talaga nila sa mapa ngayon, itong Gragas in si Queen, yung Ziggs. Pero alam naman natin na may teleport si Psyche eh. So anytime pwedeng romes po dito si Mina and Psyche para sa potential team fight dito sa dragon. But going back sa point ni Leoric, wala gaanong vision. Ito lang yung vision na nakuha nila. Mukhang si Vivi papalag na.
Uh-oh. Shyvana caught right there. You're in no man's land. And Shyvana is gonna be going down early in the fight. That's really bad right here because they don't have initiation. They don't have any smite right now. So this is, I think, gonna be an easy dragon take. And this should be 3-0. Wrap this dragon. Put a ribbon on it because that one's a gift. Jarvan 4 gets it. And here comes the fight. Blue team right here. They're not looking well so far right now. Their HP bars are already very low. So they need to get out of town. That is a 3-0. Nothing has changed. RTZ takes the fight, goes in, gets out, and gets paid 14 minutes in.
Grabe, at the tip, nahuli sila ng Mega Inferno Bomb. Nahirapan po pumwesto ang EPX. Actually, nung namatay si Shyvana, dapat hindi na nila pinursue. Dapat hindi nila pinursue. Kasi mas marami yung mawawala sa kanila. Bawas na yung teamfight prowess, wala kang smite, walang dragon, and you are giving away 3 kills. Imbis na makakambak sila sa multiple na walang dragons, kasi ilang teamfight na nakita natin kaya nila eh. Pero dahil natalo pa sila doon, they have the dragon, you have extra money, and ngayon mukhang hahabulin pa nga si Pawi, and this might also burn Kazuri's Guardian Angel, and good decision rin sa RTZ to just invade and go for a reset. Marami na sila nakuha dito. Aya babe, meron na siyang runaans, nakita mo naman si Queen, meron na rin siyang Morellonomicon and Strange Flash para dito kay Vagini.
Alright, tama. Very good call right here. I like the call on resetting right now. You want to be fully equipped para sa Baron buff push ninyo. There it is. Kaisa is waiting for the... No, blue yung inintay ni Kaisa. But still, they will need the items. They will need the buffs right now that they can take before they go for the push. Remember, the Baron buff is very important right here for this push. So let's see what RTZ, what kind of damage RTZ can do with this buff in their hands.
Yes, and right now, RTZ gusto lang nila i-pressure yung mid lane. 2 siege cannon with Baron buff. Tamang distance lang. Pawi with the cleanup. Kayang-kaya ni Fish Bones with the critical and good amount of range para safe na ma-defuse ang push na ginagawa ng RTZ. Pero mukhang hindi nakakayanin pa as 1-3-1 dito ang pwestuhan. Ito na si Queen. Magpuprosito siya dito para mararamdaman na natin yung sakit ng satchel charges any moment. Even si Aya, babe, harap-harapan ng tinotorn down itong tower, and that's about it. Another satchel sa kamay ng RTZ, another tower, good conversion, good pressure with the bar, with the Baron buff. Nakukuha na nila yung mga gusto nila.
Tama. That's gonna be a high value Baron buff right there. They're now able to, our RTZ, they were able to crack the base open onto the blue side. So now the bottom wave will keep pushing, then this will distract them in the game. 5-7 on the board. We're looking at the 3k gold lead. Medyo malapit naman yung gold lead natin eh. But the momentum of the game, the fight so far is going onto the side of RTZ. They're doing well in the initiation. So I like the momentum right now from red team. They are stealing this red buff right here. Lulu will spot this out, but will not be able to answer anything from no answer at all from the blue side.
And one good thing about that is RTZ, hindi sila nag-slow down. Alam nila sila yung ahead, alam nila sila yung may team fight capability, aware din sila sa siege capability ni Quinn. So, sila yung talagang upfront na kumakatok dito. Pero let's see, kumaka-pressure nga ba si Quinn sa ibang lane. And they are eyeing for the Baron instead of the Elder Mountain Drake that will spawn in 18 seconds.
Man, look at this right now. Kanina, kakita lang natin ng RTZ team cleaning up the jungle side of the blue side. Dito naman sa top, kakainin nila lahat. Nothing goes into the economy of the blue side, and this is slowly choking them away. RTZ side at the top is going to be pressuring a push right here as the team will continue their invade. This is total control of the game, even map control, man. Sobrang lakas ng RTZ right now.
Yes, pero yun, good movement pa rin. Hindi pa rin talaga pagbibigay ng RTZ still. Kahit sabihin nating hindi man ganun. I mean, ang maganda kasi dito sa Elder, pero teka muna, mukhang magkakabakpakan dito.
Alright, Elder Drake is already available. Papasok si Dragas dito, but will become a squirrel right there. Jarvan Force gets the last dragon. That's 4-0 dragon right there. Jarvan Force GA is gonna be... Oh no, it's not Jarvan Force GA. It's gonna be pop. Lulu is gonna be focused on by this Alistar right there. Everyone's still alive. Shyvana and Orianna is already dead. Red team, they're doing it right now, man. Three champions dead onto the red side. RTZ, VV, and the team is alive. They're now marching towards the Baron buff. They will not go for the GG push. I like this very methodical play. They want to make sure this they close this convincingly.
Yes, insurance play with the Baron buff para siguradong makapag-split push, para siguradong mapalakas pa yung kanilang stats plus the minions pushing. Sobrang pilit again. That's an Elder Mountain Drake. Although, yun na talaga, desperate play once again from EPX para maibangon yung pagkalugbok nila. Pero, RTZ, kuha na nila eh. They have the items, they have the damage, they're just waiting for the proper timing. Si Dora mag-suffer dito, even the Cataclysm being used para sa huling push.
Alright, here's the final battle of the fight. There it is. Let's cue the victory music because this one is almost over. There are four champions right here. Ziggs with ultimate right there kills the dragon. Just one, make that two. And that is gonna be the fight from downtown. Ziggs, man. Kobe for the win.